It was about 24 years ago that I first introduced legislation, when I was in politics, to have fair maps and nonpartisan redistricting.
Whoa.
And like a lot of things I introduced in the legislature, it didn't go anywhere. So it's so great, after all these years, that in Wisconsin we're actually finally going to have maps where the voters will get to decide what the outcome is. There's a name for that. I don't know if you've ever heard of it. It's called democracy. And it's about time here in Wisconsin that we have elections for the state legislature. You know, it really wouldn't have been any different for the last, ever since 2012, if we had just had canceled the elections and just said that one party was going to be in charge no matter what the public said. But finally, one year, almost to the date, after we elected a Supreme Court justice, who had the guts to say that the maps were rigged, we finally are going to have elections in the state of Wisconsin where the people will decide who runs the legislature. So it's been at least a dozen years since I'm out of politics. I used to do this a lot. I don't speak very often to groups. But I will say it's so much fun to come and say, we can celebrate first an anniversary of a successful election a year ago where we had a Supreme Court justice who stood for fair maps.
Yeah.
And right now when we're entering an election season where the people will get to decide. It's great to have democracy back here in Wisconsin. Woo!
Spenser Black, everybody. Give him a big round of applause. Thank you. Thank you.
We have another special guest. And
you broke it, Tim.
I did. Okay. So we have with Fair Maps come new districts. And here in Mount Horeb, we've been carved into another district. And this is great because Mount Horeb can be the kingmaker here. We can actually change the whole dynamics by what happens with this district. And so I'd like to invite up who is presently our assembly representative, who's done an amazing job and will continue to do an amazing job. Please welcome Mike Baer.
Thank you for your technical expertise. Appreciate that. And thank you to Swamp and to the Trolls for all the wonderful work you're doing and hosting us tonight. Thank you, Brix. We love Brix. Appreciate your investment in the community and being a place for the community to get together. This feels like this is the community center for Mount Horeb, and we appreciate you. Diane and I were here a couple weeks ago, sat right here talking with Matt and Marie about their five-year anniversary, and we gave them a certificate that they put up here by the front door, which we feel so heartened by their love. And so thank you to them, wherever they're off, having a wonderful spring break. They've certainly earned it. And thanks to staff, everybody. Tip well, help them out tonight, too. And thank you to the music. Appreciate that. When Diane walked in, I said, this is exactly what I needed after a really long session. And I had been making the joke before Fair Maps were passed, like, I'm here, I bring good news from the Capitol. But there wasn't any good news. We weren't doing good things. But we actually did do something. We got Fair Maps done and passed finally after this long haul with the gerrymander. And so with that comes a lot of changes, most of them good. So I have good news, some bad news, and then good news again. Good news is we have these good new maps. We've got an opportunity to get them the majority for the first time in so long. So long. Progress on all of the issues that we care about, child care, housing, health care, any care, creating a just economy for everybody depends on having fair maps and getting to a majority. We just can't, even with a Democratic governor, make the kind of progress that we want to make as progressives on these issues. So now we've got a chance. Bad news is I don't get to represent Mount Horeb anymore, and that really hurts my heart after walking up and down your hills and knocking every door in this community twice 2 years ago. It really has been an honor, and almost feeling choked up having to say that. But it's for the better good, back to the good news, that we get to, you here in Mount Horeb, get to be on the front line of getting Democrats into the majority. And I've seen how damn hard you work here. I've been on the other side of that, I've been with you, and I think that you are the right people to power us to that majority. So work hard this year. That's what we have to do. We have to do the work to get to a majority. It doesn't just happen because we have the maps. In this district, you'll be running against a Republican incumbent who's traditionally, historically done quite well for himself and overperforms, does better than the rest of the Republican ticket. So it's gonna take some work. Trust me, I'll be here helping you out, just as I was with winning the race for Justice Janet this spring. I know Diane will be here helping out too, and she's got big job to do 2 years from now in this same district, beating Howard Markline to get us to the majority in the state Senate. You folks, you are the ones I'm so happy are on this front line and get to be the kingmakers to get us to the majority. So thank you for your support of me. I'm here representing you until we swear in a Democrat in this seat again next term. So feel free to be in touch. But truly, my commitment is I'll be here helping you out every step of the way. Thank you for everything. Thanks for being here tonight. Thanks, everybody. Appreciate it. Woo! Thanks, Tim.
I love representing Mount Horeb. I just love it. And I know you're going to get a new state representative in the fall. I'm not sure who it's going to be. But I know it'll be on the Democratic ticket. And just so you know, in 2 years after that, you're going to get a new state senator. So if you need anything, you can always call me, okay? Because Mount Horeb will always have a place in my heart. Love working for you guys. You're wonderful. I love Troubadour. But we've all talked about how important fair maps are, but I'm going to tell you what we're going to be able to do in the next election. We're going to be able to actually move good stuff forward, like expungement, redistricting, actually get a process in place so we don't have to go through this rigmarole again. We're going to be able to do Medicaid expansion. Right now we have tens of thousands of people that don't have medical coverage that they deserve. We're going to be able to fund public schools, K-12, also colleges and universities, and stop meddling with diversity, equity, and inclusion, and realize it's those policies that continue to move our state forward in every single corner of our state. We're going to be able to do child care counts and actually help people that need child care. It's going to be great. We're going to be able to get postpartum coverage for 1 year for people. Republicans said no to that. The Republicans are saying no to reproductive freedom. We know that we don't want politicians in our in our rooms. We don't want them making those decisions for us. Those are personal decisions, and we're going to let the women make those decisions with their doctors from now on. We're going to get universal background checks. We've been fighting for that for years, and we know that's just one thing we can do to make people safe. We're going to make sure that we have mental health coverage for every single person in our state that needs it. And we're going to finally attack PFAS, that forever chemical that's all over the state of Wisconsin that we need to get out of our water, because every single person in our state should be able to turn on their tap and drink their water and know that it's safe. These are just some of the policies that we are going to be working on for every single one of you in this room. If you have other things that you want us to be working on, I am your friend at the Capitol. So is Representative Fair. We are here. You are our boss. We work for you. But I know one thing, that all of us together, we are going to continue moving Wisconsin forward. Let's do it, Mount Horeb. I'm counting on you, and you can count on me. Thank you so much.
Wisconsin's your land, Wisconsin's my land. From Dane County to the Apostle Islands, the Shawamigan Forest to the Great Lakes waters, fair maps were made for you and me. As I was voting for Judge Janet, I knew Mount Horeb could change the planet. It's a Supreme Court ruling, no more cheating. Fair maps were made for you and me. Wisconsin's your land, Wisconsin's my land. From Dane County to the Apostle Islands, the Swanigan Forest to the Great Lakes waters. Fair maps were made for you and me. Tony was signing, we all were cheering. Progressives waving, mega whining, chanting as the fog was lifting. Fair maps were made for you and me. Wisconsin's your land, Wisconsin's my land. From Dane County to the Apostle Islands, the Shawamigan Forest to the Great Lakes waters. Fair maps were made for you and me.
How about one more?
Wisconsin's your land, Wisconsin's my land. From Dane County to the Apostle Islands, the Shawamigan Forest to the Great Lakes waters. Fair maps were made for you and me.